Alrighty, so back to Stones of the Gods. I'm really excited about this book, actually. I did not actually I, now the Kindle one I really fixed, and it's really good and beautiful, and I made sure I went through the source code for code page, and it's as good as whoa, it looks professional. So yay. And it's $2.99. I'm gonna leave the price really low. I think that's better for just to get it into schools, because it's really a neat, gosh dang it, don't play with your wet hair. It's really a neat find for people who didn't know about it. You know, a neat find. So, what I wanted to discuss is, okay, in the regular book, no, I didn't take out the Devil Claw part, or the Devil Claw Raven, and I don't know. I don't have time, and then I'm almost worried that if I do that I'm gonna mess up the what do you call it, the DPIs of the whole system. So, what I really needed to discuss was the site itself, and how it happened. Now, I'm seeing two cataclysms, two major cataclysms, two major die-outs. We had the first die-out with the dinosaurs, massive dinosaurs that were there, that lived on the island. So we had a die-off that happened. Now, how that die-off happened, I can't determine if it was a change in the air, because we can have a major change in the molecules of the air itself. The quantity of methanes and blah 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 and sulfurs, it just woozed them all to sleep and they died. So it could be something like that. You can have smoke inhalation, like from a volcano, that type of thing. So they could have died from that. So we're looking at this type of die-off of the dinosaur era. So that's kind of very exciting. If we find out how they died. You know, we need to get into how they actually died. Because we were always like, well, blah blah blah, is it just this big meteor that hit, the big meteor that hit over there, or a big meteor that hit over there, another place. You know, we've had those, have them all over the planet. Some special sites. And was there one actually in the Mediterranean itself that decided to not be found yet, or located yet, that we just haven't really discovered? My thought is that there is one there, just like there is one also present there near the Cancun area. You know, the giant crater there underneath the ocean in the Gulf. So we can look at that being a possibility. Yeah, but it's so boring in a way. A meteor die-off. I kind of was liking an atmosphere change being the reason. I don't know why. Just an atmosphere change, like the ionosphere, like a switch in it. Like here you have the troposphere, the ionosphere, like an absolute, like, finagling that happened with the planet itself, that the planet, the structure of the planet, the bubble that surrounds it, the womb of itself, was just a different makeup, a different set of layers, and it altered so much that it changed them. It changed them. Okay. So, and what altered it? So we're looking at what altered it. So now, back to the site itself. Then we have, so that's the first die-off. Now the second die-off I'm looking at is a little bit more volcano-y related. It looks like a heat-off, a heat of the water itself. Could have been an underground, could have been such a big plume of lava that heated the ocean, that was it. You know, it just went on and on for a long time, and so the seas and the waters in that area The animals were driven to shore. The actual seals, the porpoises, were driven to shore. And if you see the stones, it looks like they really did try to escape the water. Like they had to escape the water. Now there are two reasons, two major reasons. One would be like a change in the salinity would be just too terrible. And another one would be the heat. So my thought would be definitely was the heat. When you look at one of the whales stuck there in stone, when you see him, he looks like he literally was being poached. So I'm looking at it being more of a heat die-off. Like, get me out of the water. It's just too hot for us. So what caused it? You can also look at, we can go back to, they used to have a big talk about, oh, every 5 years this changes, or another 5 years that changes, out there in the middle of the ocean. Come on, guys, what's that out there in the middle of the ocean? It has a, and it goes around the world. Sometimes it's cold water, sometimes it's hot water. But yeah, so we're looking at that being a possibility as to El Niños, yeah, those things, yeah. Those types of changes, but really dramatic because it was a time, you know, maybe, you know, several hundred thousand years ago, a million years ago or more. So we're just like, whoa. So, and then I'm also thinking a seal colony was there. We had seals, we don't have them really in the Mediterranean any longer, not to that degree. But yeah, there were a lot of varieties of seals. There were a lot of varieties of porpoises and otters. And it was very, very, you know, whoa, excited with water animals. So the site itself, them escaping the water, and I didn't see it everywhere, but in one area particularly. So it could be like the key to an area that was really preserved over all of these years, you know. So it's like a key, a missing link to what happened and how they became these fossilized stones. Just unbelievable. So with the coatings and the coverings, that's the deal also. I mean, we're talking about, are they hollow inside? You know, it almost gives you that impression. And there are areas where they have massive sculptures there. They look like sculptures, but they're hollow inside. Were they originally, the fossilized animals themselves? It looks more and more like it. So we're looking at giant, giant birds, and we're looking at giant, giant this, and giant, giant that, that they literally just sculpted over. So what coated them? What coated them? That's another thing, you know. So we're looking back at a lot of, it's like a mud coating, slime that they were trapped in. Mud coating, clay, lava, slime, and I mean, is that possible to burst out of a volcano and coat them? You know what I mean? Oh my gosh, I'm floored with it. But yeah, back to the escape, they're definitely looking like they were scalded. So it's actually a tragedy. It's a tragedy. We have even a shark that is like, I can't escape. I'm just getting away from the center of the water. I'm getting away from it. I'm getting as close to shore as possible. So something in the center, something in the at the beginning of the bay area was just so hot that they were all scared to shore. They were frightened and they were hurting. So it wasn't just a shark scare. where they were all, you know, trapped by a shark or a bevy of sharks, a group of sharks. No, and they were really at the mercy of the elements changing. So yeah, so I don't know. I know I go on and on, but that's really where I'm at right now with that story of getting to the truth of what happened. Yeah, so we're looking at the first die off was with the dinosaurs, the major dinosaurs, the huge ones, and then the second die off with the seal colonies, and the sea turtles, all of them that just got trapped by and the whales just saying, that's it, I'm going to shore, it's just too awful out there. So yeah, so when a whole bunch of whales are trying to leave the water, you know, it's a very, very terrible climate. So yeah, gosh, it must have been an eruptive situation. So yeah. But how old? I mean, when we're looking at stones, they would have to be a million years old at least. So, and that's before the carving. That's before the actual, you know, man decided to be indigenous, native, and go, hey, I'm going to make beautiful eyes and all of this. That's before all of that happened. And they got all weirdo. And started adding their mythology themes or adding their themes of pagan. Yeah, before all of that, you know, they were really just the animals that were there. So yeah, it's kind of a trip. Yeah, it's a trippy place.